question number 5 of NACP 2019-20. In this problem, we have a uniform disk and it is rotating with angular velocity omega about its own axis. The rotational kinetic energy is E. Over here, we have a disk of mass m. This is rotating with angular speed omega about its own axis. So we expect its rotational kinetic energy to be equals to half I omega square, and over here the value of I is equals to half m r square and omega square. So this is equals to 1 by 4 m r square omega square. Now let's read further. The same disk now rotates with angular speed 2 omega, but about an axis which is parallel and passing through the edge, and we are supposed to find the new kinetic energy. But it is rotating about the axis which is parallel to the previous axis and passing through its one of its edge. The moment of inertia about this axis was I equals to half mr square, and about this axis the moment of inertia I is equals to how much? This is 3 by 2 mr square. You can apply parallel axis theorem to obtain it. Now the rotational kinetic energy about this axis E dash, that should be given by half I dash into omega dash square, and this is equals to 1 by 2 multiplied by 3 by 2 mr square, and this omega is 2 omega, so this is equals to how much? 4 omega square. And this is further equals to, if you could see, this is 4, 3 is 12, 12 by 4 mr square omega square. And this is definitely equals to 12 times 1 by 4 mr square omega square. And this is equals to how much? This is 12 times the initial rotational kinetic energy. Thus, in the second case, the rotational kinetic energy about the new axis, that should be equals to how much? That should be 12 times E. Thank you.